Events and activities for CARIFESTA XIII being held here in Barbados are still scheduled to happen despite being dampened literally by Tropical Storm Harvey. The opening ceremony, which was to be held on Friday, had to be rescheduled. However, things are now a flurry at the Grand Market venue, with participants getting ready for the event despite the late start. So we're here at the Lloyd Erskine Sandiford Centre on the eve of what promises to be a mega cultural festival, CARIFESTA XIII. This is where the CARICOM booth is now being set up, and I have with me the Minister of Culture here in Barbados, the Honourable Stephen Lashley. And I know we've had a few glitches going into CARIFESTA XIII. We had to reschedule the opening ceremony due to the tropical storm, but I'm sure that we have a lot that we're promising and that it's going to be a mega event. Yes, Minister? How are you feeling right now?
I'm feeling quite good. No glitches, really. We've had, of course, the bad weather. And we were able, of course, to reschedule the opening ceremony. And the bad weather, of course, did have an impact in terms of arriving delegations. But most significantly, it actually forced us to reschedule the opening ceremony. But that opening ceremony has been rescheduled now for Sunday. And the entire package will still be offered. So in a sense, it's helped us to even perhaps look at, you know, the involvement of persons and ensuring that everybody can actually participate. So everything is on board. So there have been really no setbacks. We've had to do some changes in terms of placing certain events in different areas and so on. But generally speaking, there have been very minimal changes to the calendar. The calendar, of course, is offering a just estimated 500 events. So that's a huge undertaking. And we're very happy, of course. The most important thing is to ensure that all of our brothers and sisters from the rest of the Caribbean are here to celebrate what you did say, of course, is a mega festival, celebrating whom we are as a people. And I believe over the next 10 days, we will be able to see, you know, every Caribbean country showing the rest of the world the immense, rich cultural offerings of the region. Here at the LESC, where we have our Grand Market, of course, this is really going to be the, one of the highlights of CARIFESTA. CARIFESTA this year is adopting, of course, the model of pushing the cultural industries. And here at the Grand Market and the Buyer Shopping Mall, we are actually doing something that has never been done before in terms of CARIFESTA, where of course we are showing the rest of the world through the eyes of a number of international buyers who will be coming to look at what CARICOM has to offer, that the region has the kind of cultural goods that can be exported to the rest of the world. We've talked a lot, for example, of how we can break into the European market using the European Partnership Agreement. Well, we are actually making that happen. So the investment in CARIFESTA this year in Barbados is meant to be translated into taking the next steps after CARIFESTA in translating the investment into tangible foreign exchange, earning in terms of markets, and basically preparing the region for what I believe will be the beginning of a transformation of the economies of the region utilizing the cultural industry sector.
Yes, Minister, I know you have spoken quite a bit about the region, you know, investing in our cultural industries, because it seems as if this is going to be the way to transform our nations in the region in terms of economic benefits and so on. Talk to me now about the Grand Market itself. I know we're at various levels of preparation here in terms of the different booths and so on. How do you feel about, you know, the progress so far?
I think we are on track. You see that, for example, the Grand Market is offering a variety of different things. We have fashion, design, craft, and so many other aspects all in one location. So persons are going to be able to come to the Grand Market, not only experience what different countries have to offer, but more importantly, they'll be able to purchase items. And of course, we are hoping that all of the items that, you know, different delegations have brought to Barbados will not be taken back, because they'll be bought. And that translates into what certainly can be very useful revenue. And we have, of course, the Caribbean Broadcasting Corporation designated host broadcaster. They are having CARIFESTA TV, which will be beaming all of the various events, both in the Grand Market and outside, to the rest of the region and the diaspora. So you will actually, and everyone will be on the show internationally. And that's as a result of a very, very interesting, you know, collaboration between the Barbados Host Management Committee and the CBU and CBC, in which, of course, we are going to be utilizing all of the networks of the CBU stations across the Caribbean to actually give the rest of the world a taste and a flavor of what we're doing in CARIFESTA this year.
All right, thank you, Minister. And of course, we will also be bringing you updates about CARIFESTA 13. So stay tuned, and we will definitely be wanting to see how the rest of the event unfolds throughout this activity. Thank you, Minister.
Great, thank you.
The Grand Market officially opens on Saturday at noon. So head on down and check out the exhibits and items available for sale. And we look forward to seeing you at the Kensington Oval for the official opening of CARIFESTA 13 on Sunday.